Hi, my name is Lloyd, aka Lordy Ho Funk, aka King Conger, DJ King Conger. Just visit my mom's grave across the street at St. Charles. Right now we're at Beth Moses Cemetery, which is right next to Wellwood Cemetery. So don't get those confused. If you're in Long Island or you live on Long Island, you want to come to the gravesite, I made it a little easier to show you where it is. I didn't know this site was here. I know he was here for many, many, many years. And I was a big fan of Studio 54, and I was a big fan of Steve Ravel. Everybody has their own lifestyle. I'm not judging or anything like that, but just what he accomplished and I guess maybe the excitement of everything that was going on at that time. I'm a DJ, so I'm fascinated by the story. I'm fascinated about the club and how they put it together and how everything came about. So I like to pay respect. And you can see there's a few rocks on the grave. He's got his own little bench here that says Rebel on it. It's opposite of the West Babylon dumps right here, believe it or not. Last time we were here, it was like around the winter time, and it wasn't as green. It didn't look as nice. It's really peaceful over here. Well, like the cemetery should be. I don't know, man. I always dreamed of DJing at Studio 54, but at the time when I started DJing, I was 14. I was too young to even work in the club. So by the time I was 16, 17, 18 years old, the whole Studio 54 thing changed around, you know, new owners and everything. It wasn't exactly the same as it was, I think, when it opened in 77. In 77, I was 14, which is when I started DJing. 43 years later, now I'm still doing it. But anyway, found out about this site. I lived in Huntington all my life and never knew he was buried here. And I guess in my eyes, he's somewhat a celebrity. And I just wanted to pay respect. If you look on my channel, you'll see I've also did a thing on Harry Chapin as well. Total opposite, right? So the big thing on that is that I was always hoping that I could be one of those DJs in Studio 54, man. I wonder how it was like to have that kind of crowd and that kind of atmosphere. I think it was just one of a kind. I don't know if we'll ever, even with the technology today and everything else and the hype and everything else, you can never duplicate that club in that era. It was just all in a class of its own, you know. So I'm paying respect to Steve Ravel here at Beth Moses Cemetery. And if you're looking to come here and visit, just take Wellwood Avenue to South Avenue right here into Beth Moses Cemetery. Don't get confused with Wellwood. Come straight down a little ways, follow the signs, and right when after you pass, what was that over here? LeBaron. It's going to be on the left on the other side of this stone here, which is Rosen. So look on right after you pass LeBaron, look for this big stone right here on this other side. It's called Rosen. I'll put that in there. I'll put the pictures of that in there so you can see it. And he's actually right on the other side of that. You could actually go right straight past it and not even see it. All right, it's a beautiful day on a Thursday. We're enjoying the sun and the silence. Much respect to those who lost loved ones with the COVID and before that and any kind of tragedy. Much respect and love going out to all you guys who lost someone you cared about. Much love going out to Steve Ravel. And I hope that he's not forgotten. You know, beloved son and beloved brother and devoted uncle, 1989, so you're looking at 31 years ago, and he's been here all that time, and I'm now just recognizing that he's even in Long Island. I didn't know he was buried in Long Island. The Central New Yorker. Well, much respect, Steve. Wish I would have got to know you. Wish I would have got to spin in that nice club that you guys put together back in the days, but I was too young. But you know what? I'm still carrying out the tradition. I'm still carrying out the music. It's still gonna be in me until the day I die. So much love. come check it out. Sit down on the bench here, relax a little bit, take in life, you know, because tomorrow's not promised. And enjoy every minute, spend time with the people that you love, and let them know every day that you love them. God bless.